A new find at an archaeological site called El-Araj has stirred speculation that this is Bethsaida's true location. Here to greet me is one of the men who made the discovery, Professor R. Stephen Notley.
Hey, how are you?
Good, man. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So this site behind you here, I take it you think this is Bethsaida.
Yes, absolutely.
Why is this maybe Bethsaida?
Because as we look at this site, it actually has first century remains.
Right.
That indicate a settlement here. We found hundreds of lead weights that go with nets for indicate that there was a substantial fishing industry at this place.
Okay.
And here, we're right on the water.
Yes, the Sea of Galilee is lapping against this site. So we have evidence here of a thriving fishing community in the first century AD in the right time period.
Exactly.
Okay, so that's a big check mark already.
Yes, but that's not all. We've recently made a discovery that is astonishing and connects this place directly to Bethsaida. Would you like to see it?
Yeah, I'm dying to see it.
Let's go.
Stephen leads me through a very active dig site to meet his colleague, Israeli archaeologist Moti Aviam. This is incredible here. Give me some context. Where are we in the site right now?
Josh, you're in a church,
okay,
and not just any church. This is a basilica, which is a very specific architectural structure.
Okay, so Moti, when are we? When was this built?
This church was built somewhere at the end of the 5th, beginning of the 6th century.
This is the Byzantine era,
yes,
right? Take me back in time. What would this basilica have looked like?
This is a large building facing to the east. It means that the apse is on the eastern side.
So this curved area, this is the end of the church, it's the apse.
And two rows of columns supported the large roof, red tiles.
And then I'm just now noticing all of this is mosaic.
Yes.
Not just a little mosaic either. The intricate tile work stretches across the entire floor from wall to wall. Along with the mosaic floors, I read that you found mosaic inscriptions in the floors.
Yes.
Yes? How many inscriptions have you found total?
We found three inscriptions. Two of them are in the main hall. They preserved only partially. And right over here, we have the third inscription, which preserved completely. It's below your feet.
Literally below my feet?
Yep. Completely, literally.
Like under the dirt?
Under the dirt.
And why is it covered?
It's covered because we wanted to protect it after we discovered it.
And this inscription is the one that connects to Bethsaida, yes?
Yes.
Is it possible to see what's down here?
Yes, we'll have to work a little bit.
I'm not afraid of work.
Put on your gloves and let's go to work.
Oh, manual labor? Oh, I didn't realize. Before you can say Hail Mary, I'm geared up and moving dirt. The floor beneath our feet is priceless, so the work needs to be very, very careful.
Getting close?
I can smell it.
We've made it through most of the topsoil, but to see what's hidden beneath the final layer, we're gonna need to use a little finesse.
Oh. Yes, look at this black mosaic right here. This is the inscription.
Yep.
Oh my word. And this floor that we're revealing right now, this was laid down when?
It was laid down at the end of the 6th century.
So we are revealing a 1,400-year-old inscription.
Exactly. This is what we do in archaeology.
Millimeter by millimeter, we expose ancient letters from beneath the soil, but making them legible is going to take a little more work. What's the next step?
Next step is washing it.
Okay. Please.
Steve.
With the dirt swept away, all it takes is some water and elbow grease for the past to shine through.
Wow, look at that! Oh, it's just coming to life. That's unbelievable. Can I see the scrubber?
Sure.
If it looks like we shouldn't be doing this, don't worry. The mosaic has lasted 14 centuries in a harsh world. A little spit and polish ain't gonna hurt it.
Wow. My brain is exploding right now.
It looks like it was written just a few hours ago.
It really does.
I can't describe what an honor it is to be able to see this and to reveal it to the world in its entirety for the very first time.
This is unbelievable. I mean, look at this. It's extraordinary. The entire inscription is here.
Not a letter is missing.
In the news articles, I saw like a corner of this, but not the whole thing.
Really, this is the first time publicly it's being shown clearly.
This is the first time the world has seen this in 1,400 years.
Yep. Amazing, isn't it?
Huh. It's unreal. Okay, now the big question. What does it say?
I read ancient Greek about as well as I swing dance. Fortunately, Steve and Moti have Professor Jacob Ashkenazi on hand to do the translating.
Okay, so, Professor, help us out here. What does this say?
The word here, Kappa Omicron Rho, it means the chief coryphe of what?
Right, the chief of what?
Of Apostolon, the apostles.
The apostles. Chief of the apostles. Peter. Nobody else.
He is the chief of the apostles.
Okay.
The apostle Peter, who of course was from Bethsaida, was first among equals in Jesus' devout dozen. It was to Peter that Jesus would entrust his church and to whom he gave the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Now, I'm reading his title right here on the floor.
So there is no doubt at all that we are talking about Peter.
Zero doubt.
How common is it to find an inscription like this that is a dedication to Saint Peter?
Zero common.
This has not happened before.
This is a unique one.
So when you first found this, what was your reaction?
It's not a smoking gun, it's a bomb, okay?
We have, hundreds of years after the time of the apostles, in the Byzantine era, this beautiful basilica is built here and appears to be dedicated to the apostle Peter.
Yes.
So why would they have done that?
I think the church here commemorates the home of Peter, Andrew, and Philip.
Byzantine churches like this were frequently placed atop sites believed to have been the locations of biblical events. Hence, the churches became destinations for pilgrims.
This is very compelling evidence. This is something you don't often get at an archaeological site in the Holy Land, a complete inscription.
One word is missing, Bethsaida.
Right, that's it. If it said Bethsaida, then it would be a done deal.
Yeah.
But just short of that.
For El-Araj to be Bethsaida, Stephen and Moti need to prove that it was once a Roman polis, which means it has to be bigger than the single church they're exploring. An aerial scan of the site could help reveal the extent of El-Araj for the first time. If it's too small, it's a village and not Bethsaida. Let's see how big this ancient town really is.
All right, what do we have? The big moment. Whoa!
Oh!
Is this construction, all these red areas?
Yeah.
I assume that all these walls are the Roman villas, and we have it. We have houses from the Roman period.
The data reveals structures that Moti believes to be from the first century, the era of the apostles.
That's surprising because on surface you see nothing.
Right, it's just vegetation out there.
It's just vegetation.
And did you expect there would be this much here?
I wanted.
Yeah, you hoped. This is unbelievable.
Indeed.
And just for reference, this here, this is the tarping on the main site of the Byzantine church.
Yes.
And look at the size of this area.
And you can see here the edges up here and up
right.
Here. It means that the site is much larger.
Right, it must extend out.
Extend out, no doubt.
Because we see walls or disturbances right on the edges of all of this.
Yes.
I mean, this is incredible. So if you had to guess, how far do you think this site extends?
I would assume 15 acres.
In the first century, 15 acres was a sizable settlement, certainly big enough for consideration as a polis.
So when we put all of this together, right, we have evidence of this fishing village here, this Jewish fishing village on the shores of the Sea of Galilee. Hundreds of years later, we have this beautiful Byzantine church dedicated to Peter the Apostle. Now we have evidence here, geophysical evidence, that this is a polis, a Roman city. When you put all of this together, what does it say to you?
It says to me, we have here the archaeological evidence and the historic evidence, and therefore, I think this is can strongly identify the place as Bethsaida.
You think this is the place?
I think this is the place.
El-Araj, like Etel before it, has a strong case for being the city of miracles. But for now, more work needs to be done exploring both sites, and there's enough to keep these guys busy until the second coming.